moms, so I don't blame you, and we'll get lots of information from everywhere. So you need to filter what you get, okay? Not necessarily I am speaking everything under the sky. No, I'm not. I will try to focus on, number one, what is normal in a baby. Number two, what is abnormal in a baby. And number three is what are the things that you need to do. Okay, so I'll try to do that. As far as the filtering of information, it is your individual discretion as to obey or not. But at least from years of experience, having worked in UK for more than 10 years, I can give you a more or less guideline which might help you a little bit. You are happy. I'm happy for you to post these videos if you want to, or audios if you want to, and send it over to your friends who have got small babies. Maybe that will help. Okay, so we start. Before I start, I must tell you that please try to hear and listen. This 10 minutes of the talk will be of immense help to you. And the second thing is, I'll have all the questions at the end, okay? I will talk to you separately, okay? There are lots of things which seem abnormal at this age. Lots of things which seem abnormal at this age, but are basically within normal limits. Like a baby may sneeze 50 times per day. It does not mean that the child has got a cold. The baby may have a little bit of runny nose. That doesn't mean that the child has a cold. The baby might, you know, be a little chesty. So when you put the baby on your chest, there'll be a little bit of gargar awaz. In normal health. And this will be much more in the early hours of the morning and in the evenings, late evenings. So this is normal. This doesn't mean that the child has got a cold. The child may have continuously have hiccups, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70 times hiccups, continuous hiccups. That doesn't mean that the child needs water. So somebody asked me, yeah, no water at all for the first 6 months of life, whether you are breastfeeding or bottle feeding. Okay, remember, bottle feed is made with water only, okay? So, your child doesn't need water, until and unless we start off with semi-solids or solids, okay? Right, okay. The child may sleep about 18, 20 hours a day. I mean, it's natural. The baby used to be asleep inside the mother's womb, and the baby used to move, you know? So that behavioral pattern, and that used to happen more during the, you know, the wakefulness used to happen more during the night. So the baby used to move a lot during the night. So that behavioral pattern is preserved for the first 6 months, 5 months or so. And then gradually there'll be a shift. So the baby will be much more wakeful during the night. The baby will cry more during the night. The baby will demand feed more during the night as compared to the morning. Clear? And evening, they might have tantrums. I mean, they might have evening colics, which are very common in babies. So they cry a lot. That does not mean essentially that it's gas. In India, everything is attributed to gas. You have a heart attack, that's attributed to gas. You become insane, that's attributed to gas. Everything is attributed. So don't get so much panicked about gas. Children swallow a lot of air. That air goes here. There are two escape routes. One, upar se, jisko hum dhakar bolte hai, ek niche se, jisko hum gas bolte hai. So gas doesn't essentially mean that the baby is producing that amount of gas. Yeah, they do produce. But not to that extent that happens actually. So gas is a normal thing. The baby might read, angrai lena. That can happen throughout the day or night. I mean, that's a normal thing. That is nothing but the baby's movement was happening inside you. So once again, normal. The baby might be vomiting a little bit, possetting. So bringing out milk bits, curd. These are normal things. They happen. So they swallow milk, and after a few minutes, they might eject it out. And it might come in curd form. So it's acidic. Khatta khatta, dahi aisa hota. So I mean, that's normal. I mean, I wouldn't worry. And that might happen just after a feed. That might happen 1 hour after a feed. Or even the whole milk might come out through the nose or mouth. Even that's normal. I will tell you when it's abnormal. But that essentially is normal. The baby might pass 24 stools in 24 hours. Ekdam patla pani ke maafik, patla ekdam pani ke maafik poti ho sakte. Yahan se wahan tak chala jaye. That's normal. The stools may be watery, may be creamy, may be like egg bits, may be slimy, they may be acidic, I mean, they may be green. Palak paneer jaisa poti hona normal hai. एकदम पानी के माफी दही ऐसा खट्टा खट्टा डीम डीम पॉटी. आई एम वेरी गुड एट डिस्क्राइबिंग पॉटी. सो दीज आर नॉर्मल थिंग्स. ओके द बेबी माइट पास वन स्टूल इन अ वीक्स टाइम. हफ्ता में एक बार पॉटी करना भी नॉर्मल. इतना कड़ा हो सकता है वहाँ से खून निकले. इवन दैट इज सपोज इज नॉर्मल. ठीक है तो भाई एवरीथिंग इज नॉर्मल. तो भाई एबनॉर्मल क्या है? सो वी नीड टू नो व्हाट आर एबनॉर्मल. नंबर वन इज दैट बेबी इज नॉट फीडिंग एट ऑल. एक फीड नहीं हर फीड रिफ्यूज कर रहा है. दैट्स अबनॉर्मल. इफ द चाइल्ड डजंट वॉन्ट टू फीड आई वुडंट बॉदर. नेक्स्ट फीड आई वुडंट बॉदर. बट इफ द बेबी कीप्स ऑन रिफ्यूजिंग ईच एंड एवरी फीड दैट इज अबनॉर्मल. दैट इज डेफिनेटली अबनॉर्मल. इफ द चाइल्ड इज वेरी लेथार्जिक वेरी ड्राउजी यू एज अ मदर यू कैन सी कि मेरा बच्चा ठीक नहीं है. समथिंग इज अबनॉर्मल विथ माई बेबी. द बेबी इज नॉट वेकिंग अप. यू नो आई एम ट्राइंग माई लेवल बेस्ट टू वेक द बेबी अप. पिलाकर बेबी इज नॉट वेकिंग अप. बेबी इज लेथार्जिक ड्राउजी. यू नो दैट इज अबनॉर्मल. यू नीड टू सी अ डॉक्टर. इफ द बेबी इज वॉमिटिंग वॉट एवर द बेबी टेक्स. एक बार पूरा उल्टी हो गया आई वुडंट बॉदर. इफ द बेबी इज वॉमिटिंग ईच एंड एवरी टाइम जो भी दे रहा है पूरा उल्टी कर रहा है. नॉट अबाउट 30% ऑफ वाटर पूरा उल्टी कर रहा है. दैट्स अ नॉर्मल. इफ द वॉमिट कंटेन्स येलो सब्सटेंस ब्राउनिश सब्सटेंस दैट्स अ नॉर्मल. दैट्स नॉट राइट. इफ द बेबी इज हैविंग अ डिफिकल्टी इन ब्रीदिंग. बेबीज ब्रीथ डिफरेंटली. आई मीन सम बेबीज वुड पीसफुली ब्रीथ. सम बेबीज वुड ब्रीथ लाइक दिस स्पेशली द स्मॉल वंस एंड देन अगेन नॉर्मल. And then again, normal. That's called periodic breathing. That's normal. In small babies, it's normal. But if the baby breathes with difficulty, and you can see it, and the chest is going in and out, and the baby is not able to feed, the baby is very lethargic. Along with that, the baby is vomiting, possibly has a little bit of fever. You know, all these together, the baby, it's definitely a cause of concern and you need to see a doctor. Clear? If the baby becomes yellow or blue, that's a problem. If the baby becomes yellow, babies develop jaundice. Jaundice is one of the things that is very common. That's why we tested everybody's bloods. And there is no single value which can be said as the cutoff value. उसके ऊपर फोटोथेरेपी देना चाहिए उसके नीचे फोटोथेरेपी देना चाहिए ऐसा नहीं है. अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल एंड इवन ऑन द नेट यू विल गेट रॉन्ग इन्फॉर्मेशन. इट डिपेंड्स ऑन व्हाट इज द एज ऑफ द बेबी. इट डिपेंड्स ऑन व्हाट इज द जेस्टेशन ऑफ द बेबी. हाउ मेनी वीक्स ऑफ एज ऑफ जेस्टेशन. आई मीन वेदर इट वॉज बॉर्न 34 वीक्स ऑफ 38 वीक्स ऑफ 28 वीक्स. इट ऑल्सो डिपेंड्स टू अ वेरी ग्रेट एक्सटेंट ऑन द वेट ऑफ द बेबी. सो इफ अ बेबी हैज गॉट अ बिलिरुबिन ऑफ 10 on this third day of life and the baby is a big fat baby, you know, I wouldn't bother giving phototherapy. If the baby has a bilirubin of 8 on the first day or the second day of life and the weight of the baby is 900 grams, I would immediately go for phototherapy. So you have to, there's no cutoff value like that. And what is phototherapy? I told you, it's nothing but placing the baby under the sunlight. We have become much more sophisticated nowadays. We don't ride on, you know, we ride on Mercedes. So what happens is basically we put the baby under a special light and that gives you only ultraviolet light. It doesn't have the infrared rays. In fact, if you put the baby in sunlight, you never say that it's going to harm the baby. Of course it harms your baby. Your sunlight helps to manufacture vitamin D under the skin, which is very good. But at the same time, there are infrared rays and other rays which harm the baby. But we never think of that. But we get jittery whenever the baby is on phototherapy for 6 hours or 10 hours. That's not there. So if your baby's bilirubin is all right, and I think most of the bilirubins have come back normal. So if they are normal, then you don't have to do anything. So don't worry about it. But sometimes you need phototherapy. Okay, clear? Okay. So I've told you what is normal. I've told you what is abnormal. And now I'm going to talk about how you're going to nurse your baby. First of all, jitna ho sake breastfeeding do. And that is the most important point. If you ask me what are the three most important points, then breastfeeding, breastfeeding, breastfeeding. There is no substitute of breastfeeding. Jitna ho sake breastfeeding. So when you are breastfeeding, sit on a chair. Don't, like in the nursery, don't sit on the bed. Okay. Piche ek takiya rakho, haath ke niche ek takiya rakho, and feed. And feed on both the breasts. 15 to 20 minutes on each breast. And 15 to 20 minutes a baby must be awake. That is the problem. They, do baar lene ke baad, so jaate hain. So kya karoge? What will you do? What will you do? You wake the baby up. And how do you wake the baby up? Imandar ke saath imandari, bhaiman ke saath bhaiman. Amitabh ji ne bole. Utho, dhakar uthao, jagao, hilao, maro thora, do. Jagao, dhakar uthao, do. 15 to 20 minutes on the left breast, 15 to 20 minutes on the right breast. Is that clear? The baby must be awake and baby must be sucking. Now, breastfeeding is an art. What happens basically, these are the lips. This is the nipple. The moment you put the nipple, stroke the nipple on the cheek, the baby will turn the mouth towards the nipple. That's called rooting reflex. After that, you put the nipple inside the mouth and stroke the palate with the nipple and the tongue, and the baby will start sucking. Once a baby starts sucking, withdraw the nipple and then put it in again, and the baby will start sucking again. And when the suck becomes weak, again take it out, stimulate the baby, and then put it in again. That's the art. But you will discover your art gradually. But try to breastfeed. Aisa hota nahi hai ki mere ko breastfeed nahi ho raha. We hear this so commonly. Hota nahi hai. Jo bachche raste pe paida ho jate hain, unka jinke paas paisa nahi hai, to give. Their baby survived on breastfeeding only. How do they do it? So please try to breastfeed as much as possible. Mere taraf se tum log ke diet mein restrictions nahi hai jyada. So you can take whatever you want to. Try to take a healthy diet. Jitna khatta kam ho, jitna bahar ka cheez kam ho, utna better. Avoid excessive fats and all. Try to take a healthy food. And also try to take plenty of fluids. The more you take fluids, the more you suckle, the more breastfeed you produce. So that is important. Kitne der baad doge? Whenever the child cries, you're going to give it. If your child is crying within 3 hours, give it. 15 minutes ke baad ro raha hai, give it. 2 hours ke baad ro raha hai, give it. So on demand. But I will not let it go beyond 4.5 to 5 hours. If it goes beyond 4.5 to 5 hours and the child is not waking up, then wake the baby up and do it. Am I clear here? Okay? So on demand, but we will not let your babies go beyond 4.5 to 5 years. And for your little one, it should not go beyond 3, 3.5 hours because it's so small. Clear?
And how long is it paid?
We will talk later. Ask your questions later. 20 minutes on each breast, that's what we say. If at all you have to give bahar ka doodh, give it after you finish your breast milk. So 15-20 minutes on each breast, and then you can give bahar ka doodh. If you are giving bahar ka doodh, 1 ounce mein 1 chamat, 2 ounce mein 2 chamat, ounce means 30 ml. So in 30 ml of water, boiled and cooled water, you give add 1 TSM. Wahi chamat jo dabba mein diya hua hai, and level karke. So absolute level scoops, you give it. No, 1 ounce, 1 chamach, 2 ounce, 2 chamach, 3 ounce, 3 chamach, aise karke. And there is no limit that how much you can give. As much as a child takes, I wouldn't worry about how much. Okay. Call me after 10 minutes, please. 10 minutes. So, this is a normal thing. And try to breastfeed as much as possible. If at all needed, bottle feed after that. What brand you should give, whatever brand is being given from here, if at all you need to, you can. But remember, you have to boil the bottle and the water and the nipple every time you give a feed. It's better not to give in a bottle, it's better to give in a cup and spoon. Why is that? Because once a baby starts taking the bottle nipple, the baby will not take the breast. So if at all you have to give bahar ka doodh, or you can express your milk in a bottle and keep it in a fridge. Take it out from the fridge, use a bottle warmer to warm that milk up, or if you don't have a bottle warmer, pre-warm some water and put the bottle in the water, warm it up, and then give it with a cup and spoon. Am I clear? Right. The baby should have a regular bath, not a sponge. A lot of doctors also will be telling you to sponge the baby. The baby was inside a bottle of water for about 9-10 months. There is no point in giving a sponge. We used to deliver the babies under the water in the UK. So, I mean, there's no point in giving a sponge. And as far as the water going inside the ears, it all was in a water bottle for so long. So if the water goes inside the ears, nothing happens. That's a very wrong notion. In fact, if you have got a problem inside your ear, I'm going to syringe water inside so that the water is going to go, take the dirt and come back. There's a parda there and come back. That's what syringe is. So water doesn't cause any problem. Dirty water causes problems. That's a different issue. So give a daily bath, a daily soap bath from now. Shampoo at least about 3 to 4 times a week. Shampoo 3 to 4 times a week. Daily soap bath. नहाने से आधा घंटा एक घंटा पहले गिव नारियल का तेल या ऑलिव ऑयल से मसाज. तो कोकोनट ऑयल और ऑलिव ऑयल मसाज 1 आवर बिफोर बाथ एंड आफ्टर बाथ एंड बेड टाइम. दिन में 2 बार करके गिव अ लोशन मसाज. वी विल राइट दैट लोशन आउट फॉर यू. सो लोशन मसाज आफ्टर बाथ एंड बेड टाइम दिन में 2 बार. नहाने से आधा घंटा पहले नारियल का तेल मसाज और ऑलिव ऑयल. If at all you want in this days of winter, you can do 3 massages. Subha, after bath and bedtime, 3 times with a lotion. I think that's it. No tulsi pata karas, no shahad, no jambuti, no black butter, no water. Children don't need or any of these things. So there will be 2 emergency medicines with me. One will be to clear the nose. Their noses get frequently blocked. That happens because they produce a lot of secretions and their passage is very small. So the nasal passage is very small, but the amount of traffic is more. So that gets blocked very frequently. So you can put a little bit of saline nasal drop, which will be written. There will be another medicine which will be written in the discharge, which will be for colic pain, because people assume a lot of colics happening in children. Actually, what happens is when they imbibe a lot of air, that air goes, is like it wants to rise. But it gets trapped under the milk column. So the milk is coming, the air is coming, the air goes in and gets trapped under the column of milk sometimes. And it can't escape. So it causes a little bit of colic. Possibly this is the reason. Once again, nobody exactly knows what is the cause of colic. And that's why we don't have a lot of medicines for it. But this is one medicine you can keep at home. If the child is crying extensively and you are not able to satisfy the baby and the baby is still crying, then you can give it. If a baby cries a lot, what is the first thing you have to do is to see if the baby is hungry. So give them food. Give some food. Dekho patla potty hua ya nahi, peshab hua ya nahi. Clean that up. See if the room is very hot or the room is very cold. Khila bahut karo. And even after that, if the child is crying, then only you give polyclate, the drop pattern. Clear? So that's a way to handle our crying baby. Okay? There's a clip in the navel, as everybody noticed it. So that will not be there to polyclate. Uske pehle gir jayega, tension mat kar. So all you have to do is to clean it with a little bit of alcohol swab and apply a little bit of ointment, thora malam lagana. And that will be written in the discharge. So, sab kuch bhul jao. Teen cheez mat bhulna. You can forget everything I've told you today. Don't forget 3 things. Number 1, breast milk. And try to give as much of breast milk as you can. Jitna tension karoge, jitna starters dekhoge, utna breast milk kam hoga. So, baitho, vaata karte dene ka koshish karo. Jitna doge, utna breast milk aayega. Nahi doge, nahi aayega. And you have to be mentally motivated. Deha, mere ko bachche ko sirf breast milk dena hai aur kuch nahi dena. So that's number 1. Number 2 is keep yourself clean. Cut your nails. No nail polish, no mehendi. Keep your breast clean. Keep your hands clean. Whoever touches the baby has to wash the hands up to here with soap and water. And more so in these days. Okay? So make sure that baby is clean. It doesn't mean that you have to, you know, lock the room, band rakhna chahiye. There should be ventilation in the room. Okay? And number 3 is use that sense which is most uncommon to common people. So use your common sense. The day you are sweating profusely, your baby doesn't need 15 blankets. Your baby needs a fan of the AC, and the temperature of the AC will be 26. And the day you are freezing with cold, the baby needs a couple of blankets maybe. But don't overwrap the baby. Vaccines have been given to everybody, so you all guys can go home. For vaccines, you don't have to come. There are lots of things which happen after 5-6 days of discharge. The baby changes the blood circulation totally within the first 7-10 days of life. So the blood used to flow in a different way inside the baby when the baby was inside the mother. Once the baby comes out of the uterus, gradually the baby adapts to the external environment. So there are changes in blood flow. So a lot of things which don't get detected initially get picked up after 5-7 days of life. So I would love to see your baby once again. Today is Thursday. If you are going home today or tomorrow, are you going home today?
Yes.
Most of you are going home today. So please see me either on Saturday or on Sunday. If you come on Saturday, it will be 9 o'clock. If you come on Saturday, come at 10 o'clock. But see me at the